Hello friends, Doug Fink, 15 times Microsoft MVP. Today I'm going to show you how to use PowerShell to chat with AI about your data on the clipboard. It's going to be a fun one. Let's do it. Okay, you see here on my console, a couple things. If you want to play along, just do an install module PSAI and you're good to go. Grab yourself a key. If you run it the first time, you'll be given a link where you sign up for a key worth a $5 investment. Probably take you months before you use that credit from OpenAI. But anyway, what we're going to do today is we're going to take a look at this data, right? I'm going to use this data throughout the presentation. Copy it to the clipboard and let's play with it. So now I can, let's see if it's on the clipboard. I can use get clipboard in PowerShell, so we see it's exactly what we copied. Let's take it a step further. What if I wanted to, let's do a get clipboard on it. And part of the PSAI module, you can do a chat. And let's say I want to convert that data. And let's say that's to CSV, see what happens. And what actually does happen is it takes the data off the clipboard, and then chat is the integration to OpenAI, right? And that's just one of the many things that my PSAI module has and affords you. You can either use that or build your own, so you can actually take a look at the code, see how it works, and then get inspired. Use your imagination, see what you can do. So now I took this regular data, just with spaces between the values, and I asked it to converted to CSV. Let's see what else we can do. What if you prefer JSON or you need it for your project? No problem. You can do to JSON. And so it took that same data and we converted it to JSON. How cool is that? Let's get a little different and see if we can put it in HTML. See what we come up with. I'll leave you to check that out, but we get even a style, and I can actually take this, copy paste it, put it in an HTML file, and then show it in the browser. So it took all that data and converted it to a table with rows and whatnot and headers, and it looks like it might have missed one. So but you can do a bunch of different things to make that make a little bit better. I'm going to just say go step by step. So that was a bit of instructions for it, right? Grabbed some data, converted to HTML, and on its own, it figured out it wanted to do a style sheet. Let's see if we get different results saying go step by step. Nope. So that's unfortunate. Oh, well, what it did was it took the actual region and state and put it together. So I can go back and further work with that and ask it to, you know, make sure to split up all the different properties and the columns and whatnot. All right, so what else can we do? I'm going to go grab some data off of Wikipedia and I'm going to get a list of US presidents. And then we're going to put that on the clipboard here. I'll just grab this. Now you can do this with any web page, right? And here we'll just see what we have on the clipboard. And there we have, this is what was copied from the Wikipedia page. And I can do something like chat. And we'll say as Markdown. So it takes that clipboard data and it gave us back as Markdown. So that's how you can do conversions, which is cool. And then even cooler is we'll get the clipboard again. And now what I'll do is I'll say, let's say top three, see what it does. So now I have data on my clipboard, doesn't matter really what format, and I ask for top three. I'm gonna tell it what, why, or how, and top three entries based on price per unit are. So it looked up the price, looked up the units, and it came back and told me which ones it thought was the top three. I can also do something like this. Group by region. And I want to say, I'm going to misspell region, we'll figure it out. Some units. Off it goes, and it will come back, and it might even give me a breakdown of how it went about doing it. And sure enough, it did. So it figured out west and north, and so on and so forth, and showed how it did the calculations, and then it gave me the final group results at the bottom. And if I wanted to, which I won't show, is you can actually add here saying, just give me the results, don't give me any explanation or usage. That's how you can have a conversation. So here we've had a conversation with our clipboard data, whatever you want to copy and paste there, and right in the console, we're ready to go. You can even make this part of a PowerShell script, right? You can tell your users, hey, copy data, and we're going to do, we'll let you set the chat up. You can do their chat, they can use it a prompt, and then you can take that information, store it in a file, put it in an Excel file, or whatever else your imagination wants to go to. So remember, install module PSAI.chat exists in that module, and you can do this with the clipboard today. Have fun. Talk to you later.